Mike, thanks again for joining us. We've got about 20, 25 minutes left of this particular broadcast, but I want you to weigh in on this next debate. Now, many of you flooded to this particular area, Bloemfontein, Mangaung, in the Free State for the Makgoe Festival. I want you to tell me whether or not the roads were as smooth as the MEC for Public Works alluded to a little bit earlier. I'm going to bring in MEC there for Police, Roads and Transport, Mr. Butana Komphela. Your counterpart, your colleague in Public Works, spoke very highly of you, saying there are no potholes anymore, and that whereas it was a problem in the past, that's been addressed. Is that true?
Ayanda, don't fly this afternoon.
I must drive back.
But as the trucks that drove from Joburg passing toll gates up until in Bloemfontein, how the roads look like. We had 85% when this new administration started, there was 85% of roads that were not right in the Free State. Sure. We have 10 the tables around. We have 85% today of roads that are right. And we are having 15% of the gravel roads where farmers are traveling and everything. As we speak, we are working there because during the state of the province, the premier pronounced that roads for people to take their produce to the silos and everywhere for the economy of the Free State should be the order of the day. If you go there, police can able to go and do crime and prevent crime. Ambulances can travel. And I think we have a fairly good roads. And we are the second largest on roads in the country. It's KwaZulu-Natal and the Free State. But to come and see in the Free State, and the legacy of the 23 roads is gone. And we have just now advertised almost towards the end of the roads. We're dealing with the Little Switzerland, Bergville and road, which is the one that help us when there's a snow or there's an accident there. So I think we've done very well. And other provinces are asking us, where do we get the mixture or the recipe? The recipe is do more with the little that you have.
Speaking about Free State and it being largely a rural area, what sort of interventions are in place to make sure that those areas also do get attention when it comes to road infrastructure? Because as you've just mentioned, it's not just about having a road. It's an economic issue. It helps you to transport produce. It's a safety and security issue that ambulances can get there, police officers can get there, and also people can travel at will to visit neighbors, to visit friends, to travel to work. So it is quite a serious issue. It's not just about a tarred road. What attention is being paid to those in the rural areas?
Those in the rural areas, we're having good farmers. The Free State farmers are very good. We're having frequent meetings with them at the border for stock theft and everywhere. And it is the Free State farmers that would send a leaflet to the office and say, S19 is beginning to fall apart, S23 is falling apart. And because I have said to the farmers in the Free State, the MEC and the department are not all over in the Free State. We're not a piece that is all over the Free State. But through you farmers and our interaction on monthly basis on crime prevention with the commissioner, is helping us because it's them that are. The farmers in the Free State are so willing that give us a diesel, we will go and scrub the road. Help us this, where can we help? And that appetite, we're working on it and then working together with them. And that is why I can tell you now, you'll not hear a crisis of a march or roadblock of farmers because the roads are not right, because it is them who's supposed to be a hotline to us to tell us which roads are not right. And immediately, we give attention to those roads. That's how we're managing the roads in the Free State.
Commissioner, let's bring you in now and discuss issues of crime. The MEC, they spoke about stock theft, but I'd like to, which is important as well. Of course it is. It is an economic issue there, and it is affecting the farm workers. But I want to speak to something about that we spoke about a little bit earlier with regard to the University of the Free State. Two, I think, if not three major incidents of late, the passing of a young lady there and also a university lecturer who was found dead there. What is happening with regard to safety and security there?
I think, Ayanda, in terms of the school safety program, what is crucial, there ought to be a school safety committee that liaise with the lecturers, as well as the learners. Because what is important is that they should be able to report crime to the police, but also what is important, that there should be police officials from Park Road Police Station that liaise directly with that committee, and where learners are also encouraged, or students, encouraged to report crime to the police. I think in terms of racism there, it has sort of a history, and that needs to be eradicated. Already we're having an appointment with the lecturer of the university, and together with the committee, we need now to engage one another to look into this matter. I think the issue of racism is totally unacceptable, and is something that needs to be dealt with in a very aggressive manner. So regarding the lecturer that was killed, already the police have made a breakthrough in terms of the arrest, and I think we're investigating also the other matters. But the issue of crime committed also, that we're encouraging the community of Bloemfontein, the community of Mangau, it is crucial to get involved in terms of crime fighting.
Yes,
it cannot be something that is only left to the police officials alone. But also in terms of the community mobilization that we are involved in the Free State, we want to encourage the learners, specifically at the university, because there was last time, I think, an issue of assault of a learner that, or a student that was assaulted. Now, the challenge that you seem to be having is where you don't have witnesses coming forward. Now, we know in terms of the death of Chris Hani, there was somebody that was willing to come forward to say, I have seen. Mm. Now, that culture is what we need to inculcate in the province. When something happened, we should not be silent about it. But if you're silent when you see crime committed, then yourself also simply means you're associating yourself with criminals. But we need to inculcate that culture. Whenever crime is committed, it doesn't matter where. For instance, even in the case of Meiwa, people should be coming forward to say, yes, I have seen something happen. But what makes me happy in this province as a provincial commissioner is that really the breakthroughs that we have, the reduction of crime that we have, is because of the community involvement. People are coming forward to report crime. And that's why we're able, really, even in terms of the theft of cables that we had in Fixback and Velcom, and even the cables that get sold at the scrapyards, is because of people informing the police as to what is happening. And we are now going to embark on utilizing social media, where people can, you know, tweet us, people can send SMSs to us. That will lead us to the successful detection of perpetrators. So the issue of University of Free State is going to be the history, the crime that is committed there. Yes, we are aware also in terms of Kwakwa University or the campus there. We're busy with that investigation. But already we have the committee in place that is going to work. But for me, it is crucial the entire community in Puteri Cham must get involved. Through that information, we should be able to eradicate whatever crime that is committed there. Mm-hmm. So I think there is still silence in terms of some of our members, but in terms of radio communications also we have improved a lot, because we're linking with every region. We're having 5 regions in the Free State. Now we've already dealt with the 3 regions. We still have to go to Harib. We still have to go to Machabeng, where we're communicating with the people, and where also they tell us, yes, here you're doing well. Mm-hmm. You need to improve on this. And I think in the near future also, we'll be talking to them about the life system where they can be phoning. And that is starting tomorrow. Because tomorrow we're launching the festive season in Butabelo. There is going to be a life system. People that will be attending the launch can immediately go there and inquire about the cases that they've reported and where we can be giving feedback to them. So we're stepping up the issues of policing in this province.
Well, let's leave it there, at least for now, as we take another quick ad break. More of this discussion when we return. And when we come back, we go back to the floor and take a question from table number 36 at Thabo Modubi. He is a CEO at Kalahari Solutions, and he wants to speak about renewable energy. So we'll focus on renewable energy and what the Free State province has to say about that when we come back. Stay with us.